In this video, we're going to talk about a better way to embed YouTube videos onto your website. Now, whether you knew it or not, when you embed a YouTube video on your website, whether your visitor plays that video or not, YouTube pushes some assets for the visitor to download, whether they click play or not, and it makes the page a little heavier, and it certainly makes the size of the download of that page larger. It adds additional requests, and the thing that stinks is whether or not someone clicks on that play button, that's going to happen. In this video, I'm going to talk about a way in order to have that not be the case and totally customize it. Now, we're going to use an add-on for Elementor, although I'm going to give you the instructions and a resource, a page that has resources on doing this manually. So if you don't use Elementor, you don't have this add-on package and you're not interested in getting this add-on package, you'll still be able to have the resources in order to prevent this from happening. And this actually hits home for me because I have a ton of YouTube videos, as you probably already know. Hi, my name is Adam from WPCrafter.com, where I make WordPress tutorial videos for non-techies. If you're new here, consider clicking on the subscribe button and click on the notification bell in order to be notified when there's a new video. Okay, so here is a link to a website. I'm going to put this in the video description box down below. Now, these are going to be the instructions and the method to have this not be the case. And it's a manual thing. So when you scroll down here, there's going to be instructions. You're going to copy and paste a bunch of code and all of that. But there is an easier way that was recently released in the add-on package, Ultimate Add-ons for Elementor. It's right here. It's their new video element. Now, what I wanted to do in this video is see what happens when there's no YouTube video, and we see how many requests there are and how big the page size is, and then using the native Elementor widget and see what that looks like, and then using the Ultimate Add-ons one just to see what the improvement actually is. But if you come here, Ultimate Add-ons for Elementor, if you're interested in checking this out, I'll have a link in the video description box as well. You can visit wpcrafter.com/UAElementor, but the link will be down below. It's an add-on package that has a bunch of different add-ons for Elementor, but the one we're going to look at is their newly updated and released video element right here. And so let's just go ahead and jump on into it. So I have a Elementor page open. I have it in canvas mode, and this is what this looks like on the front end. So let's go ahead and just copy this. Now I'm going to be testing on Pingdom. I have Pingdom open in three different tabs. So first I'm going to go ahead and paste this right here, and then let's do our first baseline test. So this is going to be what it's like with no video on the page. Pingdom, it looks like there's a little bit of a line. So we'll just come back to this. So what I'll do is I'll go here and I'll add it the normal way with Elementor. So I have my YouTube channel, which recently hit 60,000 subscribers. So I'll go ahead and copy the link in my clipboard. So here we are in Elementor. I'm going to go right here, and here is the native Elementor video element. We'll copy and paste that in, and we'll replace this with my video right there. So let me get rid of this little bit at the end. All right, here is my video. So I'm going to go ahead and let's check on the Pingdom. Okay, we're still running pretty behind here. Okay, so I had to wait a little bit and I didn't want to leave you waiting in the video. So, okay, so here's my baseline. We have a page size of 169 kilobits, 20 requests. We're not going to really pay as much attention to the load time because that can vary a little bit. Okay, so this is with nothing on the page, Elementor canvas mode. So now what I'm going to do is go ahead and update to have this be what shows on the page. I'm going to go here. Let's just do a quick refresh. And we're going to see now the page has that video embed on it. It's got nothing else. Okay, so I'm going to leave this open here so we can look at it again later. Let's go here. Let's go ahead and paste in that URL again. Oops, there we go. And I'll put it to New York because this was the done in New York. So here it is, New York City. So we're going to do that the same. I'll go ahead and click on Start Test and let's see what happens. Okay, so we can see a big increase right here. So the page size went from 169 to 822. That's a pretty big increase. So this is what it was, 169 kilobits, and it just increased to 822, and the requests nearly doubled. Now, this is actually normal. It's because YouTube, when you embed a video, it has nothing to do with Elementor or the way Elementor does anything. It's just a YouTube thing. So when you embed a YouTube video on a page, it loads all kinds of things there, including the thumbnail. All right, so now let's go back to Elementor, and I'm gonna go ahead and remove this. And instead, I'm going to scroll down to Ultimate Add-ons for Elementor and get their video widget right here. We'll drag and drop it there. All the settings are going to be pretty much the same settings that we get with Elementor. Let me go ahead and copy the link to that video again. And then let's go back in here. Let's go ahead and paste that in right there and get rid of that. So it's the same everything. Now, I'm going to update the page. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to come back and show you some of the customizations that are available. You can customize everything, the play button. You can do some really neat things. So let me go here and do a quick refresh. And we can see now, you can see the play button change. So that's just to let us know that we are using the Ultimate Add-ons for Elementor one. Okay, so we had 169. Then it went up to 822. Now let's do a brand new test with the Ultimate Add-ons for Elementor. Video widget. I'm going to do a quick search here and let's see. This is all real time, nothing doctored. All right, so we can see here the requests went down from 39 using the native Elementor widget. And if I just embedded a YouTube video straight up, it would probably be very similar to what we got here. And then right here, you can see it went down 10 requests, which is good. But the bigger decrease is half a megabyte decrease in size. So if you're a performance junkie, and we all should be performance junkies, we should all really care about the performance of our website. So when visitors come there, they have the best experience possible. You can see when we did it this way that it is much, much faster, a much lighter page, and a lot less requests. So now let's go ahead and take a look at some of the customization options that are available to us using the Ultimate Add-ons for Elementor video element. So not only do you get these great performance improvements, you also get total customization of this. So here, let's just go through some of the settings together. So you have the same features you already have with Elementor. You can specify a start time and end time. Right here, you can autoplay. You can put modest branding that will remove the big YouTube logo right there. And you can do that. So now we have also thumbnail and overlay options. So we can put a totally custom thumbnail and we can even do an overlay color over that thumbnail. So I could do that now, as a matter of fact, right there. If I wanted to darken it up some, I could do that if I wanted to. Oops, I don't want to do a custom thumbnail though. So let me go ahead and clear that out. So that's one of the options. Then you get total control over the play button. So you can use an image or an icon if you wanted to still have it look like that YouTube play button or maybe a Wistia play button. You can go get an image of that and that could be your play button. Or we can just use an icon and it could be any icon that you want. So here is the play circle. I think that's the nicest looking one. But if you just wanted the play icon, you could do that. Or if you wanted it in a circle like that, you could do it as well. Actually, that is what I did. Oh no, here's the one that was originally there. And then we can control the size. So we can make it bigger, larger, or smaller. Something like that. And then we can control the normal state of it. And then we can also control the hover state of over it. So I can change the color right here. If I wanted to do something maybe closer to my brand, I could do that. The only thing I don't like about this is it kind of blends too much into the thumbnail for me. So a tip of advice, you might want something that doesn't blend in as much. And in order to help with that blending in issue, actually, let's go like a YouTube fiery red or something. Actually, I'm not doing so good there. Oh, that's why, because this colors are the way that they are. So I would recommend that. There we go. That's kind of YouTube-ish. But then to kind of lift the icon off of the thumbnail, right now just it's kind of flat on it, you can add a bit of shadow. So if I go here, you can see it automatically right away will add some shadow. And we can increase the shadow with these parameters. I guess it's just taking a moment to refresh right here. Okay, and then you can specify the hover settings. So for hover, I might want the color to be different. So let's go here. like this, and maybe we want it to be totally different like that. And we can also put some shadow on here, and then let's also put a animation. Okay, so now you can see it refreshed, and you can see it's lifted a little bit, and when I hover, you get that movement like that, and that would just let someone know that this is actually something for you to click on. And it's just when someone hovers, and you still have that lifted effect right there. Okay, and one of the things I like about Ultimate add-ons for Elementor is they just recently started adding this helpful information tab or setting option, but there's no settings. It's just a way for you to quickly get to information on this particular module. So there's an get started article on this module, a get started video on this module, and then there's also a, I guess this might be a troubleshooting thing if you ran into any issues. So you can see that using the Ultimate add-ons for Elementor version of the video player not only gives you better performance, which we saw when we were right here on Pingdom, we went right here from 822 kilobytes and 39 requests down to 368 and 29 requests. So not only do you get that performance boost, but you also get full customization over the experience someone has when they actually click play on the video. So like I said earlier, you can do the video optimizations manually by all the information here on this site. I will put a link down below because obviously not everyone uses Elementor and not everyone's going to have Ultimate add-ons for Elementor right here. This is a very affordable add-on. It's only $49 right now. I think it's going to go up eventually a little bit. So you can go ahead. I'll have a link down below, and you could just visit WPCrafter.com/UA Elementor. That is a referral link. If you click on that, a bit of money comes here to support the work that is going on here on the channel. So anyways, that's all I have for you in this video. This is a great feature, and it's something that I'm going to be implementing all across my website for sure, since it's very video centric. Let me know what you think about this new feature and video optimizations in the comments section down below. If you found any value in this video, if you could go ahead and give it a thumbs up to show your support. Other than that, I will see you in the next video.